अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावने वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदाजय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो Yesterday I explained about the goal of life. Krishna is not goal of life. He is only sambandha, relation. We should have a relation with Krishna. To serve Krishna is avidheya. What is this? Avidheya?
Process.
But actually our goal is Krishna prem. Krishna prem. Prem, mai seva, service to Krishna. Krishna is Supreme Lord. Very beautiful. Very beautiful. More than thousands of moons on moons. There is no word in universe to speak or to give any
proper description.
Yes. He's so much qualified. Merciful, unlimited. Oh, all qualities are in Krishna. Even so many qualities who are some opposites, all are in Krishna. You know that Krishna is Lord of Lords, Ramchandra, Narayan and all other lords. They have 60 qualities in full. These qualities are full in Bhagavat Tattva. But more four qualities, Rupa Madhuri. Rupa Madhuri means?
Sweetness of his form.
Yeah. Rupa Madhuri, Lila Madhuri, sweet pastimes. Any of the manifestation of Krishna, even Ramchandra, Narayan, Nrisimha, or they cannot play Ras with so many gopis. They cannot. Even Dwarkadhish Krishna, he cannot do. No, he cannot do. Like Krishna. So, Rupa Madhuri, Lila Madhuri, Venu Madhuri. All can fight with bow and arrow. And Krishna, oh, he will take anyone's heart by float. Very sweet. And Parikar Madhuri. His all associates are so sweet. So, Krishna is supreme. So his prem toward the prem of anyone towards Krishna is prayojan. We see Arjun. He has so much our love and affection that Krishna accepted his service to serve Arjun. All are serving Krishna, Ram, Nisinga. But Krishna is so sweet that he wants to serve his devotees. And he has promised Ananyaschintayanto Maam Ye Jana Padyupasate Teshamaham Nitya Abhijuktanam Yoga Chemam Bahamya. What is the meaning? Pundarik is here, or he will sit in the lost. Why? You should explain.
In this verse in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna is stating that those who are exclusively devoted to me, ananyaschintayantu mam, that for them, whatever they are lacking, I provide. And whatever they already have, then I maintain that.
Not good explanation. Something like Ananyaschintayanto. They are only engaged. They have engaged their whole senses. More like Uttama Bhakti. And they don't think about his maintenance, their maintenance, nothing. They are none other than Krishna. One is serving Krishna this moment. And not anything to maintain his body. There are no time at all to think all these things. No desire at all, except to serve Krishna. And if they have no time to maintain themselves, then I go there to them and see what they need, how to maintain them. I anyhow discover and then I maintain themselves. Taking the things, objects on my head carrying, on my shoulders, and I personally I, not by anyone other. So here Arjuna has no time to look after him, look after his wife and children. You know, Krishna, what did? He is training the archery to Abhimanyu Dishan of Arjuna. What he doing? He is charioteer. He is charioteer. And Arjuna gives order. And he follows the order. Arjuna told, that you should take my chariot in the midst of the both army. And he did. But Arjuna is telling, even horses are now tired. And then what did? He gave water to, and he was messaging horses, not Arjuna. What to tell Arjuna? He was messaging his horses and make fresh. So even if there was dog, Krishna can serve that dog of Arjuna, if related. You know, he could not repay Arjuna. Hanuman was serving. And Ram was pleased, but not so much pleased. He was not controlled. And by Hanuman, by Arjun, he was so much pleased. He became charioteer. He washed his horses, made them fresh. Also, he went to Shankar Mahadev, told that he will have to help Arjun because he will have to fight a big war and he should own the race. So you should give all archery, all qualities, all astra shastra,
all weapons
to Arjun. And he did. And he did order to Hanuman. Oh, you should always be with me on the chariot's
flag.
And he was there. And he told not only to be, sometimes in dangerous times you should help Arjuna and save. So he said so many times in Mahabharata. Also, he discovered a chariot and horses for and gave to Arjuna. By whom? Throw fire. You know? Agnidev. And he told that, eat your barn tarkas. Tarkas in fish.
Holder of arrows.
And good. Will not be empty any time. Never, never. You will take and it will fall. For Karna and Dushasana and others, Bhishma Pitama. Oh, so many cords. So many cords. And you know that with the arrow of Bhishma Pitama, Arjun's chariot was finished.
Chariot and
horses both. But Krishna made them alive. And when war was finished, no need of chariot, Krishna told that, now you should get down. And then I will. Then Arjun told him, why? Or you will be finished. Very quickly you should get down. He said, why you are telling so? I am telling so. No, follow my order now. And he came down from the chariot. And after that, Krishna came down. And what began?
In a second,
it was finished in a fall. Automatically. Why it began? It was finished. But in the first arrow of Bhishma Pitama. But I kept it. I kept your horses and everything. I kept Hanuman on this. He always saved you. So, what he did for Arjun? He gave him one wife, one sister, married to Krishna, Arjun, you know? Taking meal in one
same place.
Sleeping on same
bed.
How? But Krishna is not controlled. He showed his universal
form.
And he began to, Prabhu, I have done mistake. Our offenses. I will never tell you, Prabhu, Sakha. I have told all this very bad thing. So I have made so many offenses. And remembering this, he folded down. Always praying. But, you know, before that, when Krishna came to Mathura, and he told to Uddhava, what Uddhava? Uddhava, gacha, bhajama samya, pitrino, pritimava. Uddhava, you should go to Vraja. My father and mother, are weeping bitterly. They have become blind. Only skeleton. Oh, their life is for 1 day, 2 days. They can die at once, at any time, any moment. Please go and pacify them. And then he told, oh, Gopinang mad vayogi vyog avadhi matsam deshai vimochaya. Oh, also go to Gopis. My father and mother are like so that I told you. They are weeping bitterly, they are blind. They may die at home. But I don't know Gopis. That house separation, oh, top separation, they are feeling. I don't know whether they are survived or they are died. Go at once, quickly. You know, they are feeling separation topmost for me. So, you should go. Tam man manashka. Always, what doing? Remembering me. Remember. For what? For their own purpose? No. Oh, they know that in Mathura there is none to know the heart of Krishna. Krishna is very shy.
Very shy.
He cannot ask
for meal to anyone.
Bread and butter for anyone. Who will give? Oh, there is no. Jashoda Maiya, not even Rohini. So to whom? And who will pacify Krishna? Who will serve Krishna? So they are feeling separation so much. Mat prana, they are my life and soul. He had not told for his father, mother. Not he has told. Mother te taikta daihaka. They have left everything. For body, what we want. Oh, they have left everything. Everything. Daihaka means? Daihaka means? तुम नीचे यहाँ पर आकर के बैठता क्यों नहीं, यहाँ पर जगह है तो उधर में बैठता है चोर जैसा. देहका, what meaning देहका? Yes, they don't care for their body, they have forgotten all things. देहका, माम ये बोलते हैं, I am only, oh, their beloved. Malliban. They are my most beloved. Prestham Atmanam. Oh, even my soul, life they are. Jetekta Loka Dharmanscha Madathetan Vibharmeham. They have left their shyness. They have left their Lok dharma. Lok dharma means?
Worldly duties. Responsibilities.
Responsibility and not only this. What they will tell.
Social etiquette.
They have left all these things. Why? For me they have. They disobey their parents. Why? For me. They have left their maintenance. Why? For me. So I must anyhow save them, maintain them. Dharayanti ati Krishnera. They are now far away. And anyhow, that Krishna will come tomorrow. If he will die, then Krishna may die. So they are not dying. Anyhow, they are maintaining their lives. Only their life is life उनका बचा हुआ है केवल जब मैं कल आऊंगा इस पर.
Their life is only sustaining because they know Krishna is going to come tomorrow.
Because Krishna has promised, he cannot break his promise. He must come. So tomorrow he will come. Tomorrow he will come. And that is why they have kept their life. Anyhow, I think that they have not kept their life, my shabd, because their life in me. So I am maintaining. Otherwise, they would have been finished. Go at once and see whether they are died or not. If not dead, then pacify them and Uddhav them. He has not told anything like this to anyone. To Pandavas, to Arjun, never. To the queen of Saptabhama, Rukmini, nothing. Why? Because they have boundless, causeless love and affection for Krishna. And that is object. That is most high. The love of Krishna, which was in gopis. Especially, you can know that all the gopis, like Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, Champaklata and all, Rukminjari. They were serving at that time, pacifying Radhika. Who can pacify? Who can pacify? To whom pacify? See, Radhika was totally mad. No sense at all. So others were pacifying because they were incensed. No? Lalita, Vishakha, all were incensed. Their love is so high. More than millions of Uddhav Prem. So high. More than millions and more than Satyabhama Rukmini. More than even the Sakhis of Vrindavan. But in comparison of Radhika, not so high. So Radhika was totally mad. And Uddhav saw. How he saw? In Bhramargi, a bumblebee. Oh, also this bumblebee was Krishna. He went to Braj in the shape, in form of bumblebee. And he saw Radhika totally mad and he was sleeping in a bed of rose flowers, petal flowers. And it was dry. So much chandan was given, cool, but even it was fried. She was dead or in life, or he could not imagine what she was. And she was sometimes very angry, more to Krishna, criticizing Krishna, abusing him. So, cheater, ungrateful. Even Satyabhama and all other cannot tell Krishna like this. Or Mother Yashoda Nanda Baba even cannot tell like this. That gopis are telling, ungrateful. You are like bumblebees of 6 feet, more than animal. Animal, human form had 2 legs and animals 4 legs. And butty, or like this bumblebee, 6 legs. So they are more than any animal. Comparing him. Oh, so many things. We don't want to have any relation with that black person, with black heart. Black, like bumblebees. We know there was a ram, also black. And who was he? What going? He cheated Surpanakha and... So there are so many things. So Srimad Bhagavat is the explanation of the love of Radhika, glorifying Radhika's love. So the love in Radhika is topmost. Oh, this is the goal of whole world, living beings. They cannot receive like this. Never. But a drop that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave to Rupa Goswami, endless ocean of nectar, of rasa, bhakti rasa. He gave one drop. And even one drop can sink whole universe. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave this. If we can serve these gopis, especially to Radhika, then we can have a love affection for Krishna, and then we can feel separation so much, otherwise never and never. So this is goal of our life. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Goswami has, and Srimad Bhagavat Sukadeva Goswami has, in final touching, they are telling this conclusion. That our goal is what? Krishna prem. But like home? Oh my, like that. So, Krishna told to Uddhava. And now he knew that gopis have so much love and affection for Krishna. But he has no experience still now. No? He heard that gopis are most beloved of Krishna. Krishna is most beloved of gopis. He knew this fact. But how their love is, how tall, and in what way, and what is that love? He had love for Krishna. Like, oh, he is my Prabhu. He is like my brother. He is like, oh, so many things. But not, Krishna is not telling anything for Uddhava like so. But he is telling to Uddhava, go. Why? Oh, you should go and realize what is prem to me. In Mathura, there is none like this go. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, out of his mercy, sprinkle a drop, anarpit charin chira, and this is our goal of life. Uddhava went to Braja. Why I am telling all these things? Made it clear what is the goal. First make a goal, and then process. If there is no goal, what is process? Everywhere it has been told. Nigama kalpa taruru galitam phalam sukha mukha adayam mrita darva sanjutam ivata bhagavata rasamalayam maho rasika bhurbha. Oh, this is object of Srimad Bhagavatam. Three slokas from beginning are explained in Srimad Bhagavatam. Especially 10th canto is explained only Nigama Kalpa Taru Granta. How Srimad Bhagavat? Krishna is the ocean of rasa. So our object is all this love and affection for Krishna. Like gopis. Like to serve Radhika. Like this. Now Uddhava went to Braja. He has so much love and affection for Krishna. But a new thing, totally new thing for him. And when he kept his left left in Braja, and he realized what he saw. He saw Krishna is playing everywhere. All the sakhas are playing with Krishna. Oh, millions of cows hankering after Krishna. And so much of big horse. And milk is automatically. And cups so beautiful, charming, white, blacks. And they are jumping here and there. Bulls, oh, big bulls of Nanda Baba. What doing? Fighting each other. And gopis are what?
Charming.
In the morning, he saw that scene of morning. Of very beautiful lamps in gopis' rooms of ghee. Not like this. Dead thing. And ghee. Very, what? Snigdha. And so much fragrance coming everywhere from flowers. Bumblebees, what doing?
Humming.
What? They were blowing the shankha of Kama.
Sail of Cupid.
Everywhere birds were singing, cuckoo birds and peacocks. Oh, what doing? Kekha and dancing everywhere. Sakhar were like this, and all the gopis chanting and doing Govinda Namo Narayane
Govinda Namo Narayane Govinda Namo Narayane Govinda Namo Narayane.
So beautiful gopis, mothers. Yashoda was so much beautiful, so much extreme. And that is why Krishna became so beautiful. If mother was not beautiful, how he can come? Then he would have been only black. Only black, no beauty such, coming like pearls. So Krishna was so. So Yashoda mother, all like this, he saw, and in a moment, the scene was dropped. And then what he saw? All are weeping for Krishna. Oh, Krishna, very well. He saw. Cows are not going to graze. All weeping. Keeping their head towards, eye towards Mathura. Calves weeping. They are not taking milk from the udder of their mothers. All are weeping. Peacocks not dancing. All are like blind. All like mad for Krishna. This in his heart. And now it became evening. Anyhow, he entered and bake with. He saw the love and affection of Mother Yashoda and Nanda Baba. And he was. What? Struck drum?
Dumbstruck.
Oh, he could not imagine how high class of love and affection can be. Now he realized something. of how high class of love and affection. But when in the morning and he went to Kadamba Kiyari, where all the gopis met and about to die there. Anyhow, by the mercy of Krishna, he saw the gopis there. And he reached there. And he saw and realized something. And for this thing, Krishna has sent Uddhava to go to Vrindavan, try to be admitted in the school of gopis, where I was admitted. And then you should return back, and then we can speak something about love and affection. So go, and we first qualified. But he was not qualified to be admitted in the school of, because his numbers were about 25%. And there they needed what? More than 85% numbers. So they rejected. But he went there in the school and saw all very high class of students are there, and professor and principals were there, like Vishakha, like Lalita Vishakha, and principal herself, Radhika. And then he saw, and then he prayed, Bande Nanda Prija Istrinam Padarenum Avhikshnasam Jasam Hari Kathot Gita Punati Bhonantre. And now he knew the glories of gopis, how they love Krishna. He had never seen like this. And now he felt that if I want to love Krishna, then I must be admitted in this school, but I am not qualified. He requested gopis that if you are not admitting in your school, can you please take me like a servant to give water, like a servant to clean the school, college? Oh, they rejected also. He was not it. No. You should go and return back, then be qualified, and then you can broom here. Even you cannot broom. You cannot broom our kunja. Can he do?
Not qualified.
Not. So, he was praying now. Bande Nanda Braja Istrina. Who are Nanda Braja Istrina and all the gopis? Beloved of all the of Krishna. I want to pray, offer myself. I want to keep one even particle of your dust, food dust. If one particle, can you tell that particle of what, which a special gopi, then it must be of Srimati Radhika. Brahma cannot attend this. Shankar cannot. Even Satyabhama and all others cannot. So Krishna has sent him to see the glory of the gopis. Then he is telling, seeing glory. He saw the Himalaya, the peak, highest peak,
Everest.
And he saw like this.
His cap fell down.
He cannot become, could not become like that. He had to return back to Krishna, empty hand. Only that Sandesh was there. What Sandesh means? Message that, I went there. What I saw, very strange, very wonderful. I cannot explain all this. You told, it is told true, more than you told. But I could not realize anything. So I had to return back. Bande Nanda Braja Istrinam Padainum Apikshnasa Jasan Harikathod Gita. What they have told, that Brahmar Gita, in Gopi Gita, Jayatite Dhikam, in this Tava Kathamritam Tapta Jiva, in this thing. And it will purify whole universe, whole universe. If anyone recite, even they will remember this thing, what will be? Really, all will be purified. So you should try to recite all these things. You should try to know all these things. Meaning are very deep, very deep. Swamiji, your Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami, wanted to give this of very wonderful things, this object. But yesterday I told, he could not. Why he should plant this in
barren land?
Barren land or no?
Desert.
Oh, he should make that land fertile, cultivate, and then he would. He wanted. But in the meantime, oh Prabhu, Radhika called him. Oh, come at once, we need your service. So this is our goal. Asha maho, charan renu juham. Rasa maho charan reni jusam aham syam brindavane kimap gulma lasau dhisa jadusta janghat svajan arjipatan jahitva bheje mukunda padavim sati bhi. If not of Radhika, lotus feet dust particle, even anyone in Vrindavan, Braj gopis, and I will be satisfied with that. I don't want the dust of Krishna lotus feet. If I want to please Krishna, then I will have to take a part of your boots. So I want your mercy, causeless mercy. This is the object. And then we will come down the process told by Srila Rupa Goswami and Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Narottam Thakur. Same thing in new bottles. But wine is same. If you take that wine, you must be mad. What is the... No harm. The color of bottles are
different.
No. But wine is same. So we will explain the process from beginning. Adau Saddha, then Adau Sadhu Sangha, then Saddha, Anattham Nipitti Ruchi, then Asakti, then Rati Bhav, and after that no sadhana, no sadhana at all. Only the mercy of gopis is there. Go, Pramad.
Haribo!
Today is perhaps drama also. You should do a quick. They should announce it. Then.
Hare Krishna.
Also, you should make a place for drama.
Hare Krishna. Some devotee has requested for initiation. So initiation is tomorrow 8:30 a.m. So who have registered their name with Jagmohan Prabhu? I am requesting you all who have registered their name with Jagmohan Prabhu, they will come to Gurudev's Bhajan Kuti 242, room number 242, 8 a.m. Who has not registered their name yet for initiation, please register your name tonight with Jagmohan Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Don't forget bring things to truth.
To devotees. One day, Maharaj Yudhisthira asked Narada Muni some questions.
Oh, my dear Narada, you've been very kind to explain the proper behavior for brahmachari, vanaprastha, and sannyas. But I have a question. Would you kindly tell how someone in the household order of life can live properly according to the Vedic injunctions?
My dear King Yudhisthira, those who stay home as householders must act to earn their livelihood. But instead of trying to enjoy the results of those actions themselves, they should offer those results to Krishna. How to satisfy Krishna in this life can be fully understood by association with the exalted devotees of the Lord. A grihastha must associate again and again with sainted persons in order to fully understand the position of a grihastha. The first duty of a grihastha is to be fully dependent upon Krishna and to try to satisfy him with devotional service. This devotional service depends upon the instructions of the spiritual master. The beginning of devotional service is called shraddha, or hearing. One must hear from the mouth of pure devotees. In this way, the attraction to his wife and children will gradually be reduced. As for the maintenance of his family, a grihastha, while earning what it requires for a living, should not be overly eager to earn more money than necessary simply for sense gratification. A grihastha must always remember that one who is attempting to accumulate more wealth than necessary should be considered a thief and is punishable by the laws of nature. A grihastha must treat all animals like his own children. And whatever he may possess, he should distribute equally to all living entities. The best process for this is to distribute prasad. A grihastha should not be overly attached to his wife, but he should engage her in service to Krishna with all attention and to guests that come to the home. A grihastha should only eat prasadam, and he should travel to all the places of pilgrimages mentioned in the Puranas. In this way, a grihastha should be fully engaged in worshipping the Supreme Lord, Shri Krishna. My dear King Yudhisthira, a person who is surrendered to the Supreme Lord, the ocean of nescience becomes like the water in the hoofprint of a cow. I will give you some examples of this from my own life.
Mahakalpa, which is a millennium of Brahma, I existed as the Gandharva known as Upabahana. I was very respected by the other Gandharvas. I had a beautiful face and a pleasing, attractive bodily structure. Decorated with flower garlands and sandalwood pulp, I was most pleasing to the women of our city. Thus, I was bewildered, always feeling lusty desires. O most exalted Upabharana, there is a Sankirtan festival glorying the Supreme Lord coming this way, and all the Gandharvas and Apsaras are invited.
Yes, yes. I too shall join the parade and add my beautiful voice to the rejoicing. rejoicing. Come, ladies, let us sing.
Jayanake, Jayakrishna, Jayanake. Therefore, must curse you. You were to become a Shudra at once, to become devoid of all your beauty.
Oh no! How unfortunate I have become because of my sinful activities.
Therefore, because of my offense, I was born as the son of a maidservant. One day, my mother instructed me.
My dear son, today our lives have become so greatly fortunate because for the next 4 months, you will be serving some very exalted sages. I give you full responsibility to see to all the needs of these sages. I want you to tend to all the desires of deep devotion. If you please these sages, hold still your mercy on me.
Yes, Mother. I'll do as you instruct and serve them to my best ability.
Thank you.
gods, during two seasons, the rainy season and autumn, I had the opportunity to hear these great devotees constantly chant the unadulterated glories of Lord Hari. As the flow of my devotional service began, the covering of the modes of passion and ignorance vanished. I was very much attached to those sages. I was gentle in behavior, and all my sins were eradicated in their service. In my heart, I had strong faith in them. I had subjugated the senses, and I was strictly following them with body and mind. After that, the great Mahabhagavats left on their travels, but I remained because my mother was dependent on me as her only son. But one day, as she went to milk the cow early in the morning, a snake bit her and she died. I took this to be the special mercy of the Lord, who was always desiring benediction for his devotees. So thinking, I started for the north.
That during this lifetime you will not see me again. those who are incomplete in service and who are not completely free from all material taint can hardly see me. O virtuous one, you have only seen my person once, and this is just to increase your desire for me. Because the more you hanker for me, the more you will be free from all material desires.
Traveled the earth chanting the glorious pastimes and remembering Sri Krishna. Having obtained a spiritual body, I gave up the body made of five elements. And at the end of the millennium, when all created beings enter into the body of Lord Narayana,